Mozart, Mass in C, Kirchhell 220, the Sparrow Mass. We will be performing the Kyrie, Gloria, Sanctus, and Agnus Dei of Mozart's Mass in C, Kirchhell 220, known affectionately as the Sparrow Mass. This nickname is attached because in the Sanctus movement, the grace notes in the violins imitate the chirping of sparrows. Listen for them just after the slow introduction of the Sanctus, following the words, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth. Mozart composed this Mass in February 1775. Due to Archbishop Colloredo's edict that Masses could be no longer than 45 minutes, Mozart had little time or space for imitative counterpoint. Most of the Mass is set in the homophonic style. The Gloria begins with a chant intonation sung by Roberto Padua.
Gracias. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Our first piece is the Missa Super Por un Plaisir by Blasius Amon, the Kyrie. Little is known about Blasius Amon other than he was a Franciscan friar, singer, and composer in Austria. As was common in the Renaissance, he based the movements in this Mass on a popular chanson. In this case, Por un Plaisir, or For Pleasure, that was too brief, was written by Thomas Crequion. It was published as a four-voice chanson in 1543.
Thank you. The Fairest of the Fair is a 1908 march by John Philip Sousa. One of Sousa's most melodic and less military-style marches, it was composed for the annual Boston Food Fair of 1908. It is the only work of any kind that he composed that year. It is claimed that the memory of the pretty girl he had seen at an earlier fair inspired the composition and the title of the march. This march is one of Sousa's most tuneful, with memorable, singable melodies featured throughout. As with most of Sousa's marches, this wonderful march conveys a spirit of excitement and happiness.
Yardbird Suite was written by alto saxophonist Charlie Parker and presented here in an arrangement by Mark Taylor. The tune, which references Charlie Parker's nickname, Bird, in the title, is an AABA example of 32-bar song form, one of the most commonly utilized musical forms of the bebop era. Solos are Steve Dix on trumpet and Valiant Taylor on alto saxophone.
Pater Noster, Our Father, by Sigurd Thor Severson. This is a modern setting of the Latin Our Father text. The text is perhaps the most famous prayer in Christianity. Composer Sigurd Thor Severson belongs to a new generation of Icelandic composers who are gaining popularity in the worldwide choral community. Iceland, a gorgeous but sparsely populated country, has a long history of music composition rooted in folk music that is combined with Central European-influenced art music. The undulating accompaniment, with constant 16th notes in the right hand, is set over a repeating bass line known as an ostinato. The three-voice setting expands to four voices at the climax of the piece right near the end. Thank you. The next piece, The Luckiest, by Ben Folds, was arranged by Carrie Marsh. This popular song appeared on the 2001 album Rockin' the Suburbs by Ben Folds. Since the mid-2000s, he's appeared with many symphonic orchestras, even composing and performing a piano concerto with the Nashville Symphony. This piece is a bittersweet love ballad celebrating both young and old love. The solo is sung by Elizabeth Belfiore.
Thank you.
Prelude, Siciliano, and Rondo was originally written for brass bands, for which England is well known. It was titled Little Suite for Brass. This version was arranged by John Painter, which expands the piece to include woodwinds and additional percussion, but faithfully retains the breezy effervescence of the original composition. All three movements are written in short, clear five-part song forms. The design is instantly apparent to the listener while giving the imaginative melodies of Malcolm Arnold and a natural, almost folk-like setting. The prelude begins bombastically in fanfare style, but reaches a middle climax and winds down to a quiet return of the opening measures that fades to silence. The second movement, the liltingly expressive Siciliano, is both slower and more expressive, affording solo instruments and smaller choirs of sound to be heard. It too ends quietly. The rollicking five-part rondo provides a romping finale in which the technical brilliance of the modern wind band is set forth in boastful brilliance.
Thank you.
Shiny Stockings, composed by Frank Foster and arranged by Mike Tomorrow, is a swing classic from the library of the Count Basie Orchestra. Known for its attention to time, the subtleties of articulation, and emphasizing dynamic contrast, the Basie Band stands out as one of the premier ensembles within the international jazz community. This relaxed rendition features all sections of the band, with solos by John Wilkes on alto saxophone and Jeff Olson on trumpet.
Thank you.
Our first piece is Cantate Domino by Hans Leo Hassler. This text translates as, "Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing and give praise to his name, for he has done marvelous deeds. Sing and exalt and praise in songs with the harp and the voice, for he has done marvelous deeds." It has been set three times by Hans Leo Hassler and has been set countless times up to the present day by other composers. Hassler was a late Renaissance composer, publishing this work in 1601. Note the contrast between the homophonic sections, where all voices move at relatively similar times, and the polyphonic sections, where the voices move separately. Several of each may be identified in this short piece. Be ready for a majestic ending at the words mirabilis eius, or marvelous deeds. I Will Sing by Rosephony Powell. Composer Rosephony Powell has composed a secular concert work that is in the style of a gospel spiritual. It contains a social justice message. I'll sing of the love, of the peace, of the hope. I'll sing of the joy that fills my heart when freedom rings. Listen for characteristics of the gospel style, such as call and response, repetition, syncopation, and backbeats.
I will sing, I will sing, I will sing of the joy that fills.
St. Thomas, written by Sonny Rollins and arranged by Mark Taylor, is an upbeat, catchy melody reminiscent of the calypso melodies heard on the Caribbean island of St. Thomas. Originally released in 1956 on Sonny Rollins' landmark record, Saxophone Colossus, the tune has become a favorite of jazz musicians around the world. This performance will feature solos from John Wilkes on alto saxophone, Steve Dix on trumpet, Casey Etter on trombone, and Trigg Stewart on baritone saxophone.
Thank you.
Our final piece, Build Me Up Buttercup, was arranged by Sean Connor Anderson. This pop soul song hit number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100 in 1969. It was more recently revived in the 1998 film There's Something About Mary and in the 2020-21 Geico auto insurance commercials. Listen to the layering ostinatos of the bass, tenor, and alto lines, and for the entrance of the chorus by the sopranos. The basses get to sing the verses, I'll be over at 10, you tell me time and again, but you're late, and to you I'm a toy, but I could be the boy you adore. Tenors grab a bit of the melody at, baby, baby, try to find a little time and I'll make you happy. I'll be home, I'll be beside the phone waiting for you. In the 1960s, this piece was considered a pop song and a Billboard hit. If it were composed, and it was in French, in the 1560s, it would be called a chanson, just like the chanson from the opening Kyrie. I guess it remains to be seen whether someone will compose a mass based on Build Me Up Buttercup. Perhaps for an upcoming sabbatical. We'll see. Enjoy these pieces.
Build me up, don't break my heart. Build me up, don't break my heart.
Why do you build me up? Why do you build me up? Why do you build me up? Don't break my heart. Why do you build me up? Why do you build me up? Why do you build me up? Don't break my heart. My heart. What do you build me up? Build me up. Why do you build me up? Why do you build me up? Next year my heart will build me up. Now you'll be me. Why do you build me up?
Pick Up the Pieces, written and recorded by the Average White Band, was a funk hit in 1974, reaching number 20 for the year of 1975 on Billboard. Unique for the time on the popular music charts, this tune featured a funky guitar part with a repetitive horn line and soloists. There were no vocals, other than the occasional shout of "pick up the pieces" from the band at large. This version, arranged by Mark Taylor, features two soloists, Joanne Hillier on flute and Matt Pem on tenor saxophone.
Thank you.
The name George Gershwin is legendary in the world of American music, having spanned both popular and classical genres. I Got Rhythm, Embraceable You, some symphonic works such as An American in Paris, Rhapsody in Blue, Summertime from the opera Porgy and Bess, and the seldom heard piano prelude are all included in this beautiful medley, arranged for concert band.
Thank you.